tonight. We're not going to be in one of these services because it knows everyone to tell us. The pastor called me this morning because he just got me from the call and said, I had an opportunity to take a Sunday night service night for the teens. I was like, Pastor, I'm talking about. And so I went to this healing communion service. So he said, how do you? And he said, be prepared to step into the anointing, pray for sinful, and you'll see people here, teach, and then have the community. He said, how do you? He said, you're going to be. I said, you're going to be able to teach. And he said, I'm going to be able to teach. I've never been here with somebody in the family's so, he said, well, it's healing night. So, he was not that big to talk about, but he was going to be through the blood. I'm going to say, I don't know what's going to be doing. I'm going to be praying about that. Because, my initial response was some of the best healing teaching I've ever heard in this county from this program. This pastor will start, he knows the book. He understands the anointing. He understands the mechanics of the way this stuff works. That's why I spent the course of years that we sat under him and under his anointing and under his ministry, that changes our daily lives. So, starting up and saying, I'm going to teach somebody to heal, following him, that would be the best idea. So, what I want to do tonight is, I'm going to read some scriptures. We're going to see how what the Spirit of God kind of takes us. I think we're going to be really encouraged to see maybe I do, maybe I don't. But I know what to say. So the what we need to do is we need to make sure that our faith is built up so we can receive from God. If we do that, we won't be able to receive from God. What does Psalm 17 say about the scripture says? Take things from there and hearing the word of Christ. If you have your Bibles tonight, I want you to turn over to Mark chapter 5. We're going to take the most of what we do back from there. I like this story a lot. I've always loved this story.
Gertrude is what I call this lady. Gertrude is just such a blessing.
In verse 21, when Jesus had crossed over the gates, he had seen the boats on the side of the road, and he said, "Stay by the seashore." And he had seen all the fish that were in the waters, come up, and he had seen them fall on his feet. And he prayed his words, and said, "My God, who is at the point of death, please keep me away from these animals, and she will get well." And he went. Well, that's a very cool story. And we don't know what's going to happen. We don't know what this guy's background is, and we don't know who he's been listening to, or who he's been teaching, or whatever. But he knows one thing. Jesus, if you come here and give us my daughter, so we may go. Verse 24 says, "And he went out with them, and a large crowd was following him and pressing him on him." I think it's really interesting in this story, take those two things. Take what Jesus to move, and also get Jesus to stop. You know, what about those of us who are hearing the story? Jesus said, "He's got a crowd following him. He's a crowd following this man everywhere he went." He's teaching about love and about God and what people have never heard before. And all of that, every time he goes to, he heals everyone. And a lot of people follow him. Everyone's talking about him. Everyone's heard about him. Jesus came up and said, "You come in here and raise my daughter. I said, you will." And Jesus said, "I'm not my daughter." But it's impossible to know. But Jesus came up and said, "You're not sure for the world. And thus, in Jesus' name, so now you can make my vote to be taught. So, if you do this, it will happen. In verse 25, a man who had a good works for 12 years had endured multiple years of many physicians, and had spent all that he had in his money up to all but the credit for the universe, and to learn about Jesus to get up and pray for him to touch his clothes. Thank you. putting the time in to build your faith up, and that's what it takes. It takes time. It takes time. How does it say faith comes? The King James says hearing the word of God. The other translation of the word says hearing the words of Christ. We have a right to hear the words concerning Christ. Does it mean that? No. There is faith. My faith is so built up based on hearing people tell stories about God moving through their lives. That builds me up. Now, according to that translation, that is what builds you up. You start telling stories of glorifying God, magnifying God. Can't believe what God does in your hands. You start telling these stories, all of a sudden you start getting pulled on the inside, the spirit man rises up, that faith starts to grow. That's that faith we have to pour out to get God to move in our life in a situation that we really reach God. And then, I understand, we need to take time every day to be reading, confessing, and putting in scriptures. If it's done in the spirit, it builds us up. Cause that spirit man to get big. Cause his God to get bigger to us. And he says, how long is it the guys in the books on the right, the in the Old Testament, not the magnified God. I mean, look at that, the magnified God. But did they make that any bigger? No. They didn't make that any bigger. That's as big as he is. But look today. We start saying praises to God, the person things to God, and glorifying God, and all of a sudden, God gets bigger than you. You do magnify God, but you magnify him to you. He doesn't just get bigger than you, but he gets bigger than you. And faith gets built up, it gets stronger. And all of a sudden, you say, God, I thank you. And you start quoting your scriptures, and you say, man, you need to be quoting scriptures where we are. But then we need to be putting clear and clear scriptures up in our life. You don't want to wait till, you get a bad report from a doctor and say, hey, we need to start reading 2 Peter, 1 Peter 2, 24, we need to get out of our strengths. You don't want to start there. You don't really need to get built up before that. You don't want to get a chance to attack you with a car or a door and you slide them out and you give them the keys. You pull the book out the way Jesus did. You say, oh, yeah, this is what the book says. This is what the book says. And that's what you're doing. And you try to put something on you. You stand up and say, no, I'm not going to take it. I'm not going to take it. My God calls it on you. I mean, you can't see the person of the world. See, you can't touch me. My God. And so, see, this book is the truth of the world. And there's some people that they're really good with me. I know a guy who's in the ministry. He's been in the ministry all the time. He also graduated from the union. He was watching the perpetrator divide the telephone. He couldn't back down and have a union. He couldn't. But when he was a young man, he hadn't even had a passport. But tell me, I don't even know what he was doing at the time when he went to church. Some of us have been there. He got some crazy disease. If I remember a few days. And a week and a half later, the doctor said, Demons and all good that the demons come to heal diseases, and the people not to proclaim the kingdom of God, and to proclaim healing. That's what we're supposed to do. He gave us this authority. He gave us this authority. This is something that we have. We have to be walking in this. And if we step out and walk in this, God will perform. Chapter 10, verse 9 says, whatever sin you went to receive, you will see you, you will take before you, and he will be those who are sick. Is this important to Jesus? What is he telling everyone to do? What's this about? Thank you. reason. I'm complete 100% reason. I'm not going to say I need to follow me. I'm going to get to you. You want to know what to do to me. It's a really good idea that what Jesus can do is true. So go preach here. I think it's really interesting. The Lord spoke to us to go heal the sick. 5:8 says, "This prayer, Jesus and I are first talking, we do not go in the way of the Gentiles, and do not enter into the city of the Samaritans, but rather go to the lost sheep." Verse 7 says, "And as you go, preach, saying the kingdom of God of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, listen to this, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons." Is what you're supposed to do. I don't need authority to do this. This is what I want you to do. Go heal the sick. Go heal the sick. Freely you've received, freely give. Go heal the sick. And if the sick who tells you to go heal the sick, you do it. Only that spreading of sex and self-righteousness. Is that right? It's about to hear you do it, isn't it? Get the spirit of God, it's going to be a poor, just like me, Christ. This is the power of God that heals. But just like when you receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, you speak in tongues. The Spirit gives utterance, but you speak in tongues. It's always going to be healed because you're going to lay your hands on your obedience to God's word. It's because you're going to move in the anointing of the gifts of the Spirit. It's because you're not activating your faith and you're going to do something. You will accept the healing of sin. You will heal the sin. You will accept the rest of them. I'm going to tell you what it is. I'm going to tell you what it is. boxes next to our little club. Two tables were up. One day, one of these teams of buddies, I think it was the South Engineering, he had no cars about that, but the way I remember the story, he said he was going to do a funeral service. He said something really cool. He said, don't worry about it. He said, don't worry about it. He said, I'm going to do it. Smoking is a cross man. There's another way to go up there. But apparently, he's going to go up to see it on the way, or when he got there, or whatever. So go watch that guy. Don't you go to the next place here? Because he's right back in the body. So, you need to be with him. I'm going to go.
This is the spirit world. This is where you
kids and they get their cars and the houses they have, and thank you.